once again, Empty Force, Advantage, Michael Baisden Group, and Emadwaleni. I'd like to say thank you once again for your aid in making this a success. It was you done the event, we were into the buses. All right, but thanks again, once again. A round of applause for everybody.
Allow me, there is a man, you know, that I feel very sad if he doesn't come forward to address him. He is key in helping the students or the former pupils working with the school, because that is the relationship we want to nurture, so that all these kids, when they leave the school, they must not forget where they come from. They need to come back and work with the school, and this is the seed that we are trying to plant.
Good morning, everyone. Mr. Cole has made me a very important person. I was not hoping to speak to him because whatever we do, as former learners partnering in the school, I think it's just about it's a lot's worth, I guess. We are not doing it for the commission, it's just to plan them what was given to us. On behalf of the school, the parents of these learners, former learners that I represent, we call ourselves friends of Emadwaleni, because we think that we believe that it was this school that we were molded. And today we are because of this school. We started about 10, 11 years ago to get together as former learners and come back and see how we can make this school. And a lot of things have happened. We've helped, I don't know how many learners with registration fees to go and study further things. We will come here for motivation, just to speak to the learners and say they should not be discouraged, because at some stage we will also be here. And it has worked wonders. We thank God for the work that has been done. But most importantly, we thank you, our esteemed visitors. It's best just like this that we leave a seed in the life of these kids that we will reap for years to come. It's very personal for me, and I know the principal always laughs at me and always expects the worst for me when I start speaking from my heart about this, because I get emotional. When I was at the school between 1984 and 1989, I could not afford a pair of shoes. And I always tell these kids when I come here to say, if I had given up to the pressures that I was experiencing from peer pressure, I would have left school then and not finished the school and become what I am today. And I always say to them, and I love saying this, and I say that in this life, today, because of the persistence, the support that I got there, I did not allow the fact that I did not have school shoes to let me give away my dreams. And later on, today I always say to them, and I still say that, I can give away from my own wardrobe, a pair of shoes, and not one shot of shoes. And I say this to say, whatever that you are experiencing, don't let it determine your future. Don't let current circumstances, you know, give away on your future. One day you stand up here and you of my thank you for good being, because today the school, the parents, and these kids, we are because of you. We want what you have shown us, and thank you very much. And please continue.